We are getting closer and closer to the 1 year anniversary of TYT's lockdown. Most people's lockdown initially happened around a week from that point. And it made me think, you know what? Along the way, considering the fact that we're still in this pandemic, it is still doing so much damage, and it was as horrendous as it was and didn't have to be. We're going to start looking back on some of the steps along the way that got us to there. Some of the most outrageous decisions, ways of talking about the pandemic. And one of the early ones that I felt like we could not miss was this prediction from Kayleigh McEnany. Take a listen.
This president will always put America first. He will always protect American citizens. We will not see diseases like the coronavirus come here. We will not see terrorism come here. And isn't that refreshing when contrasting it with the awful presidency of President Obama?
Kayleigh McEnany, thank you so much. Good to see you tonight.
Thank you.
As bad as that quote is, and that's what we're gonna be talking about, is it Trish Regan? Her like, you nailed it, Kayleigh. That like end was really condescending from my point of view. Anyway, Brett, isn't it refreshing that we won't be having diseases like coronavirus come here? Isn't that refreshing, Brett?
To be fair, she wasn't wrong. There are no real diseases like coronavirus. I mean, it's an unprecedented disease. So yes, coronavirus itself came here, but she didn't say that. She said diseases like coronavirus. So the undiscovered pangolin-borne illnesses, who knows, because I'm not gonna look it up. The other things that are crawling around inside pangolins, they're not gonna come here. And we have done an excellent job, 100%, making sure that no other COVID-like diseases, and I know that COVID itself is an umbrella, but we all understand that. No other disease quite like it that's capable of shutting down an entire world will come here. And so far, they're 100% right. It was just the one.
It was just the one. Do not Google COVID-19 variants. It was just the one. It was just the one. Now look.
But those are made in the USA.
What's that? Exactly. We're gonna have to figure out a name for this segment. But anyway, this is one of the most outrageous ones. Not just because, oh my God, we've already lost 500,000 people. How could you say that? But how could you have said that, really? Like the idea, I understand she may not have thought 500,000 people will die, or even that at that point, 50,000 people would die. At that point last year, I didn't think anything like that would happen. But the idea that it would not get here at all, that nobody would get sick, that's madness. It's late February. Late February 2020, it was in many countries. I mean, it was already here, but we didn't know at that point. But it had already spread to so many countries. The idea that it was never gonna get here is madness. And the idea that you could just say that and what's the difference if it eventually gets here? No one will care. And I guess largely most people don't care about most of these things, but it was just there was no chance that it would end up being true. There was no argument to be made, and there was no pushback from Trish Regan. What a mad thing to say on the precipice of this absolutely horrendous year.
And so you, once again, are, you know, really tackling this on the merits of what she said, but I can answer your question. Mm-hmm. As to why she would think it was okay to say this. We all know that she said something that was ridiculous. And why would she, and you're kind of asking, why would she think it's true? And she doesn't, is the short answer to that. And why does she think she could say something that's so obviously not true? Because of the other thing you're talking about there, that Trish Regan won't push back. That every step along the way, no matter how big the gaffe, mistake, or intentional evil deed is perpetrated by someone with an R next to their name, or someone that they think by siding with them will gain them more viewership or defectors from the other side. The entire Republican and conservative media infrastructure is set up and incentivizes people to do exactly that. To say things that aren't true and that later will be laundered. So, and it bore out recently. We did a segment on the Young Turks where we pointed out how the guy who quit as a police chief of the Capitol Police in the wake of January 6th didn't apologize, or he resigned, and now
he kind of
unapologized and said he regrets resigning. Why? Yeah. Well, look at what happened to Ted Cruz. Ted Cruz did a terrible thing. And 3 days later, after it was clear that he lied, Sean Hannity's on there laundering his image, saying you just went and dropped the kids off.
Yeah.
So let's take a step back.
wink, wink.
And there is no longer any incentive for anyone to tell the truth or do the right thing or apologize or resign in shame, because the right wing media infrastructure is so damn shameless. You got Tucker Carlson on there saying like, there's no science behind it, when there is. He just is saying things. It's nuts. Yeah.
Well, and there, so that mechanism doesn't exist, and it's not going to. I mean, like, you can't, like, if we got the right people and the right presentation, we'd have some sort of neutral arbiter of what's true, and we could check the facts. No, Republicans hate, they now are incredibly suspicious of and dismissive of the concept of fact checking. Because again, like, the idea that everyone would equally want to make sure that their facts are correct presupposes that everyone values the truth. And to say that some people don't might sound insane, but I'm like, you know, when someone shows you who they are, believe them. They don't care that what they believe isn't true. And they're not gonna be shamed into believing something else because you prove to them in some way that it is true. But yeah, then that's absolutely insane. You know, we're gonna eventually get into the stuff that Trump has said. We're starting off with Kayleigh to sort of dip our toes into the water of COVID insanity. But yeah, it got a lot worse than she was willing to admit, at the very least.
Check out the Damage Report podcast each day, wherever you get your podcasts, whether Pocket Casts or Stitcher or iTunes. You can join me as I give you the news and stories you want, with a range of co-hosts and interview guests jumping in on the fun each day. Again, that's the Damage Report, wherever you get your podcasts. And if you get them at iTunes, don't forget to rate and review. Sometimes I'll read them live on the show.